Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. In this video, we'll cover organolithium reagents. The top line on this slide features the synthesis of a Grignard or organomagnesium reagent. We've seen this in a previous video. In reactions that actually use Grignard reagents, I like to draw the Grignard reagents as an ionic structure. Let's do that in this case. So we have a carbanion, and the charge of the carbanion is balanced by the complex ion MgBr+. Organolithium reagents are remarkably similar. In the lower reaction, we react our halide, not with magnesium, but with lithium. This is lithium metal, lithium in its zero oxidation state, Li0. I've shown the organolithium with a covalent carbon-lithium bond. We can draw this ionic as well. In fact, I would draw it ionic if I were using it in a reaction to highlight the nucleophilicity of the carbon. So let's draw that structure. Again, we have a carbanion, and it's balanced by our metal, lithium in this case, lithium plus. There is a question with the organolithium. Where did the bromide go? It is lost as lithium bromide. The metal reduction requires two electrons. For magnesium on the top in the Grignard reagent, the metal has two electrons in its valence shell. One magnesium can make one Grignard reagent. Lithium only has one electron to spare, so we actually need two atoms of lithium zero to get our two electrons to form our product. The second atom of lithium binds the bromide. You could put a 2 over the arrow in front of the lithium, but most people don't. This omission is an artifact of organic chemists not being strict about balancing reactions or always showing all the products, like lithium bromide. Both of these reactions use ethers as a solvent, ether, diethyl ether on the top, and THF, tetrahydrofuran, on the bottom. This is typical for organometallic reagents. Grignard and organolithium reagents are often used interchangeably. Both are fantastic nucleophiles. In some cases, people favor organolithium reagents, which are slightly more reactive. Unless stated otherwise, it's generally safe to assume that the reagents both perform the same chemistry.